everyone, you're watching Gabe and Louise, and for today's video, it is gonna be how I edit my Instagram photos, plus how I plan my feed, or how I curate my feed, how do I decide what to post next, and all the juices that comes with it. I'm going to spit it out in this video, so if you wanna know how this goes, just keep on watching. So if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel, comment down your video suggestions, like this video if you liked it, and watch all of my other videos like my Shopee hauls. Without further ado and further plugging, let's get down to the video. So first things first, I just wanted to divide this. So we want to get super duper organized, and we have a timeline right over here, so we will be super duper specific, accurate. I just want it to be like very organized because I'm a very organized person, but I'm blabbering too much and this is going to be very disorganized. So number one, I just wanted to quickly say that all of my pictures in Instagram are taken with my iPhone 6s, so medyo mababa na yung quality niya, but still for me it works. As long as it you know, pleases my eyes or my standards or my, you know, expectations for a photo, it works. So yon, nag-settle lang talaga ako dito. But then for the filters, ganyan, dun talaga nagle-level up. You have to really vary, choose your filter, the right filter that suits your aesthetic or whatever. And as for me, ito yung ginagamit kong phone, nothing else, nothing like digital camera or like a professional camera or like an upgraded iPhone, basta ito lang talaga. It still works like super duper good. Yeah, I might upgrade, pero you know, as long as it works, can still, you know, use it. So for the camera naman, next naman is what apps do I use? I usually use Vesco. Alam niyo na yun, guys, how I edit my photos. If you haven't watched that, I already did that, pero yung how I edit my photos, I really vary kasi hindi lang talaga ako nag-base sa Vesco. But for my feed, Vesco talaga, because they have like variety of filters and I do like that. And I also can control yung ibang settings. Unlike sa other, very limited lang yung settings ng app. So, sa Vesco talaga, nahanap ko na talaga siya and like all I need. But I'm not really fond of using Lightroom. So, if you are using Lightroom, I'm very sorry, pero hindi ako masyadong sanay or hindi ko masyadong gamay yung Lightroom because sobrang detailed na, like furthermore pa sa Vesco. And I think it's really better to have that na marami kang wider variety of options. Pero for Vesco, tama na yung technicality for me, so I just settled with that. So for some of you na have watched my how I edit my photos, I purchased the premium account on Vesco. Okay, so first things first, you are probably seeing now yung pinaka raw photos, unfiltered, na mamaya i-edit natin. So it like goes along with my feed. But for the furthermore part, ito talaga yung pinaka feed ko. So I'm going with this parang white, beige, you know, minimal aesthetic only, because mas madali siya, you know, i-edit, mas madali siya i-partner since I have this room na pure white, minimal, medyo maraming gamit na white din because I really love it. I'm even wearing white. Basta parang more on white, beige tones kasi yun talaga yung aesthetic ko and gusto ko lang talaga mag-keep ng minimal, clean, parang ganun yung vibe ko in this feed. So yeah, you are seeing my future feed. So I'm using the filter M6, so we're going to start editing this photo from my Shopee haul. So this photo is like pure background white kasi nga I wanted to keep this white aesthetic. I'm going to use my favorites, yan yung M6. So hindi ko talaga sinasagad na full filter because I don't want it to look like super duper filtered, but then it looks like super duper filtered. Medyo i-tone down natin ng onte. Tapos the key is exposure since I have this white, so mas maganda na parang nagbo-boom talaga yung white less the other colors, so medyo mataas yung exposure niya and the contrast also, so para hindi masyadong namumuo yung white talaga, hindi siya nagbo-boom like white. So meron pa ding other colors, meron pa ding purple, meron pa ding black and gold mix skin tone. So done with the contrast, we're going to sharpen. I really love this tool kasi for some iPhones, sobrang nagiging grainy, kaya itong sharpen na tool na to, mas maganda kasi parang mas nagiging precise. Would you look at that? sobrang nagiging outlined, yun yung term, right? Term, nagiging outlined talaga yung photo. And I love it about that. So, saturation, onti lang naman, like 0.4 lang, because I just wanted to like pop of color pa rin, kahit na white na yung background. And some highlights, maybe konti lang, ganyan. I don't really get, but I guess mas nagiging accurate and mas nagiging, alam mo yon, parang nagiging highlighted yung photo, kaya nga highlights, diba? Yung skin tone, more on the warm side of the temperature, ano ko, kasi pag dito, magiging pink, so dito tayo, medyo dyan, 1.2. And then, Vignea, I don't really use that. For white balance, I won't be, hindi na ako magde-delve into that, kasi okay lang naman yung temperature ng color and the tint. So, let's put on some green, onti lang naman, like, so, pag zoom mo, hindi naman masyadong grainy yung texture. Basta onti lang, just strike the right amount. This one is one of my favorite tools kasi kapag gusto ko ng parang colorful na photo or yung sky, yung sunset, mas na-edit ko siya dito. And mas, alam mo yun, mas lumalabas yung kulay niya. So, for example, this lavender top is like the center of attention right now. So, we're going to amplify that color. So, we're going to like, sagad natin yung saturation, the lightness, and the hue. So, medyo compared sa last time, di ba, hindi siya masyadong like more on pastel-y. But this one, you can adjust it more on the bluish side or more on the pinkish side. Yeah, that's how it works. So, ma-adjust mo pa yan. But for now, I'm not going to quite use that. Siguro onting option lang. That's it. It's just so simple. Ganun ko lang ginagawa yung mga pictures ko. And then, I just copy that filter and then paste it on my edits, the other edits. So we're going to edit this one. This was taken earlier in the morning, like mga 9 a.m. I was just so gloomy. So this one perfect example na kapag paano kapag hindi super duper white yung background ko. So we're going to try and do that. So first things first, let's put on the filter. Minsan talaga nahihirapan din ako na i-edit siya, lalo na kapag you know, kapag hindi talaga sakto yung exposure niya and yung the aesthetic, hindi sumasako. So, medyo na-frustrate talaga ako kasi I wanted it to be on my feed. So, parang hindi siya bagay. So, it's like some dilemma. So, contrast, let's just amplify that a little bit. And, sharpen, my favorite. So, parang hindi pa rin siya nagmumukha. So, hindi pa ako, you know, contento dun sa exposure niya. But now, it's quite okay. Lagyan natin ng onting fade because it seems like nagiging grainy siya. And also, let's put on some highlights. Onti lang. Yan. So, that's it. In that way, mas bagay na siya sa feed ko. So, mas nagko-complement na siya sa feed ko. By the way, you guys, ito, ibang filter to. This is quite the filter that I'm going to use for my IG shop. So, if you haven't aware of that shop, please follow, it's Say Lovie. It's Say Lovie's. I don't really quite understand why did I pick that name. Check out nyo na lang. I'm going to leave the username down below. But for this one, I'm going for vibrant yellow. Super duper vibrant ng theme ko doon. So I'm going to use the V2, but let's not more on delve on that. And also with this one, I want to edit this tone bag. Same with the M6 whitish tone. You can also use the AL3. And some A6 and A4 yon. Medyo ano yon. Ayan, that's it. Kahit wala na akong i-edit na ganyan. Let's apply this filter to this photo of me. Done! Ganun lang kasimple, guys. As in, copy-paste edits. Pero kung hindi siya talaga siya nag-a-apply, so I can adjust it a little bit more. But yeah, that's just how I do it. Walang halong kineme na sa Photoshop and whatever. And let's try to do this thing. By the way, guys, lahat ng mga pictures ko on IG is not like from Pinterest. I always edit it on my phone. I always take it on my phone. Kasi yung iba, di ba, parang nag-create sila from Pinterest. Like, say, Nadine Lustres, she gets it from IG users like the Youth Club. I'm going to just share it with you guys something soon. So, ito, I just took it earlier. So, I just wanted to show off this necklace na nakalimutan ko isama sa Shopee haul. But don't worry, you guys. There's going to be an upcoming haul. So, dun ko na lang siya i-discuss. I just wanted to, like, yan. And then, let's then the contrast on the lang. And then, just wait. it's better if you guys have this booming light para mas maliwanag, since mas maganda talaga na may lighting na maayos. Kasi nga mahirap na super dilim, tapos o kaya powered lang by flashlights or powered lang by yung mga bulb light na ganyan. Mahirap siya i-edit. It turns out to be super super duper grainy, lalo na sa iPhone, kasi hindi naman, alam mo yun, hindi niya napipick up ng maayos yung features mo o kaya yung features ng product or ng object. So yeah, mas maganda na parang natural sunlight. So I really suggest if you guys take pictures from 1 PM to like mga 4 PM, dun maganda talaga yung golden hour, lalo na between 3 PM to 4 PM, as in sobrang ganda. Ayan, that's just it. So edit lang natin to ng onti kasi medyo hindi siya ano, yan. That's it. Yun lang naman, guys. How do I really plan my feed? So the question is, how do I really plan my feed? Basically, I don't really have that much planning. Pero nagsistock lang ako ng mga photos like what you're seeing right now. As in, sobrang nagsistock lang ako ng maraming white na babagay din sa photo. And then I just pick like a day na parang every other day or every 2 days ako nagpo-post on IG. But then like there's not much na super duper na okay, ganito, ipopost ko to sa ganito, ipopost ko to sa ganito. Actually, I get really a hard time planning or posting something on my feed. So parang nag-struggle talaga ako, you guys. If you are really subscribing to my Instagram, if you are following me, sobrang-sobrang dami kong pinopost muna. Like, ititignan ko muna dyan sa pinaka-grid. Then, parang kapag hindi siya bagay, didelete ko, hanap akong bago. And then, basta hanggang makuha ko yung right photo na mag-fit na sa previous photo. So basically, I don't really have that much planning. I just stock up my photos on Visco. Pero kapag hindi ako consistently nagpo-post ng picture ko by picture by picture by picture, because dati, ganun talaga ako. Like, gusto ko ako lang talaga yung laman ng feed ko. I don't want that. So parang medyo nag-shift na ako kasi dati, ganun yung ginagawa ko. I'm, by the way, using the A4 filter for that. So kahit na picture ko siya, syempre mahirap, diba? Kasi since you have like different background, mas maganda na ganito yung filter, but yung previous photo mo, iba yung filter na yun, so hindi siya babagay. Yun yung parang pinaka-dilemma ko before. So I thought na mas maganda na gumawa na lang talaga ng feed, cohesive and coherent feed na parang nagmamatch sa aesthetic ko. So I just finally settled with that. Mas natuwa naman ako kasi parang mas naging productive yung quarantine, and I get to show off things na parang aesthetic for me na hindi ko masyadong sinoshow sa vlog, ganun. So I get to post it on IG. Kasi satisfy lang yung creative juices, creative side ng mind ko. It's really fun to plan out your feed, ganun, kahit na hindi siya organized. That's just how I do it. And I think it's not really like a big deal, but for me, sobrang nakakatuwa and nakaka-soothe ng mind, nakaka-satisfy ng, you know, ng parang creativity side, imagination side ko. Maraming inspiration sa Pinterest, by the way. So if you wanna get ideas on how to take a picture of your room, how to take a picture of your clothes or your nice objects or whatever, some pictures of you also, marami sa Pinterest, you guys. It's just how I get my inspirations and stuff. Kung ano lang na dito sa room ko, yun na lang talaga, dun na lang ako nag-settle. So you get to work with what you have, and yeah. I just think that's great. That's the end of the video. Thank you so much, loves, for watching. And I hope you really enjoyed, because I really love discussing my creativity side or whatever. Is it really creative or not? Thank you so much, loves, for watching, and I hope you really did enjoy. Please subscribe to my channel, comment down your video suggestions, like this video if you liked it, share this video. I'll see you in my next vlog. Bye-bye!